Thank you very much， 谢谢大家，特别感谢李太太又一次给我这个 sunflower 这个太阳花 ，sunflower was given to me by Mrs. Lee， who's in her 90s， I thank her again。 Sunflower represents hope， 太阳花呢代表希望。 就是会带给我们波东巴塞区美好的希望。My dear Potong Pasir residents and voters, I want to start by thanking you for all the encouragement, the support, and the feedback you have given me in the last 4.5 years. And for that matter, in the last 15 years. It was only because of your trust in me, and it was only because you allow me to build a relationship with you that we have arrived at what we have achieved today. A few days ago, I was campaigning at the Potong Pasir MRT station. I met a gentleman who was a resident and who moved out of Potong Pasir 5 years ago. So he told me that he was happily amazed at the developments of Potong Pasir in the last 5 years. I told him, if you can, please come back again in another 5 years. It will be much, much better. Just a short while ago, some journalists asked me, can you put one word to your campaign to describe what is the key factor in your campaign? I thought about it. I said, yes, I can put one word. The one word is continuity. We have to continue on our journey. The structure is up, the house is up, but there are still many details that we have to do. Where do you put the curtains? Where do you have the room so that grandmother and grandfather can stay, which is more convenient? Where do you put the study table so that the children can study? All these minor details are very important to all of us. 各位亲爱的波东巴塞居民与选民，首先呢，我要感谢大家在这4年多以及这15年给予我的鼓励。 给予我的动力，给予我的反应，给予我的支持。因为你们，我们才能够到达今天这个位置。但是，我们要继续我们的旅途。其实呢，我在这次的大选是以感恩的心来处理。 计划，为什么感恩的心呢？因为你看这个恩字，这个恩字上面是一个因为的因，下面是一个心，所以感恩呢，就是因为您给我的机会，我会用心去做，我绝对不会辜负您给我的希望与期望。 I'd like to talk a little bit about some of the challenges that we have been facing in the last 4.5 years. One SPP supporter who walked past me last week said, anyway, Mr. Sito, you have done all the upgrading. Now we just walk in, very easy. Actually, it's not like that, you know. Because yes, the structure is up, as I said, the house is up. But there are many, many more details we have to do. I'll give you one simple example. In Potong Pasir, Senate Estate, and Lorong Toa Payoh, within our whole constituency, we have to fix the drains. Our drains is actually a problem. You know how much drains we have? About 40 kilometers of drains. We will try to cover up as much of the drains as possible, but the drains have a problem because the gradient is a problem. We have to fix that. All right? Because when the water doesn't flow, mosquito breeds. All right, when water is stagnant, mosquito breeds. And this is just one of many problems we have to face. The second issue that we had was, I think in another SPP interview, Mrs. Chiam said something along the lines that, oh, if I'm given the resources that CITO have, I would have done wonders. I like to say that the resources that we have in the last 4.5 years, yes, it is enormous. We did get resources from the government. But so did Aljunied, so did Hougang, so did Punggol East. But what many people do not know is that apart from the government funding, the Akong funding that we get, as Achua told you, we actually had to raise substantial sums of money on our own. Because very often, as I walk around, residents can tell me, oh, you know, there are steps there. The old people cannot walk up the steps. Can you do a ramp? I turn to my town council officer, and he say, boss, no budget. I say, don't worry. Just go and do it. I will go and raise the money. And that is the attitude that we have been doing. I'll give you another example. Because of residents' feedback, we moved the soccer court from block 143 to behind block 109. Because the residents of block 143 and 139 were complaining about the noise, so they wanted it to be relocated. So we relocated that. I can tell you, more than half of the cost of the soccer court came from our own fundraising efforts. In the course of our work, we have to lobby agencies. Honestly, it is not easy. It is very challenging. What are the agencies we talk to? We have been talking to NEA, PUB, HDB, URA, MND, SLE, LTA, etc., etc., etc. Trust me, when you deal with the agencies, it can be very challenging. Very often, this is what our residents want. I will start from what our residents want. And very often, this is what the agencies are prepared to offer. And after many, many, many meetings, if you can meet somewhere in the middle, you have done very well. I went through and looked at my records for the last 4.5 years. Actually, I'm also very surprised. We actually had more than 500 meetings with the respective agencies. More than 500 meetings in the last 4.5 years. So the question, maybe I like Mrs. Chiam and her team, and also maybe our residents to think about, is even if I take it that you have all the resources I have, even if I take it, you will raise all the money that I raise, do you have the energy and the drive to power this through? You need to power this through because it is not easy. I想 谈一谈我们这四年多来所面对的挑战，因为曾经有一个 SPP 的支持者，我跟他碰到面，他就跟我讲啊，司徒先生，放心，你都做得七七八八了，很好很好，我们这次大选我们就可以走进来了，不用做太多的事情。但是事实上，事情没有那么的简单。 因为我们的基础是打好了，对，我们的基础是打好了，我们的屋子是盖好了，但是里面还有好多好多的细节，比如说一个例子就好，我们的沟渠水流的不是很顺畅的，大家知道，我们浦东巴西区大白窑八巷，新立新村的沟渠，坦白说是有出了问题。 这样我们要维修我们的沟渠，总共有40公里的沟渠，这种细节呢是需要不少的精力，难度也不容易去维修去处理。此外呢，有一些SPP 的支持者也说，哦，你这几年得到政府的津贴的资金不少，如果我们有的话，我们也同样可以做 更好。但是我想告诉大家，对，我们是得到不少政府的资源，同样的其他的反对党区、阿育尼区、板鹅东区等等也有得到这样的资源。但是呢，因为我们的市政理事会经济能力不是很强，坦白说我们要自己去筹自己的款。比如说那个新的足球场，我们从大牌143移到大牌109嘛，有一半，超过一半的资金是我们自己来筹款的。偶尔居民也说，哦，要做新的扶手，要做等等的设备，往往市政理事会的成员都跟我讲，老板，没有 budget， 没有这个业绩。我说不要紧，去做去做去做，因为我会自己去筹款。此外，即使 SPP 它真的有我们所有的资源，我想问一个问题，因为我们在这四年多内跟政府机构，我刚才讲了，跟 NEA、PUB、HDB、URA、MND、SLA、LTA 等等开了500多个会议，这500多个会议是来来往往的，我们要这个东西，我们的居民要这样的要求，他们只给这样，如果可以在中间碰面呢，是非常非常好的事了。要得到我们这个突破，需要非常大的精力，非常大的力量。可能大家要想一下，他们有这份突破的力量跟精力吗？因为难度的确是很高的。I'd like now to talk about Kampung spirit, because this Kampung spirit issue keep cropping up in the last 1 month. First, I'd like to say, in whatever we do, I make it an effort to retain and to maintain the character and the charm of Potong Pasir. This is what our residents want, and this is what I will do for you. I make pains to make sure that is retained. Second, Kampung spirit doesn't mean you have to stay in a kampung. Right? Doesn't mean you have to stay in a kampung with no amenities. You can stay in a nice environment and still have kampung spirit. To me, kampung spirit means caring for each other, being happy with each other, and everybody's happy and caring. I'll give you a few examples. I have many, but I just give you some examples. Kampung spirit means being happy together. As you may be aware, every 1 or 2 years, we organize trips to overseas for our residents. We have gone for many, many. I think residents who have joined us will know this. But in the last 4.5 years, we have gone to Malacca, we have gone to Desaru, we have gone to Penang. Let me just talk a little bit about the Penang trip. Achua just now talked about A, B, C, D, right? We are all A, B, C, D in Potong Pasir. Whatever we do, we act beyond the call of duty. Very important. So let me just tell you about our Penang trip. We had 500 residents going on the trip to Penang. It's not easy because it is a 16-hour journey up by bus, 16-hour journey down, 19 buses. The oldest participant is 90 years old, 90 years old. The youngest participant is 18 months old, 18 months old. And there are 171 residents who are above 65 years old. So, my team and I started planning for this trip. Now, firstly, I told my team, very important, everybody go up there happily, enjoy themselves merrily, come back safely. Very, very important. So for the residents who are above 65 years old, we don't all put them in one bus. Huh? We deliberately spread them out in our 19 buses. And in each bus, I have 4 volunteers. They didn't know I was doing this, but I was doing this. I said, I told these four volunteers, every half an hour, go and check. Uncle, auntie, okay, ah? They say, okay, good. Right? Now, and then, we, Troy and I debated. 19 buses, 18 were occupied. There was one spare bus. Troy and I thought about it very long. Should we have one spare bus? Because 18 buses traveling in convoy, going up to Penang. Then in the end, we say, ah, never mind, better have the spare bus. Lucky we have. You know why? Coming down, Achua and I were in the spare bus. We got a call. Because every half an hour, report position. They say, one bus in Taiping broke down. Aircon breakdown. So we say, okay, never mind. Our bus will go there. So then we disembark the residents on that broken down aircon bus, went up. And then Achua and I take the no aircon bus back. Never mind, we're very happy. We're very happy. All right? To me, that must be acting beyond the call of duty. I'll give you another example. Every last Sunday of the month at our community club, we have an event called Sing Along. Because I've been discussing with our residents, and I've been discussing with our residents as well as our team members. I said, I want something every month where residents can come, can be very happy, can exercise a little bit. And then they say, okay, about 1.5 years ago, we started this sing-along session. It started with 120 people 1.5 years ago. Today, it's 500. The hall is packed. In fact, I have a little bit of a problem, but never mind, it's not a big problem. Our residents started bringing non-residents to this event. There's about 20% that's non-residents. I cannot chase them away. I mean, I welcome them, but we're starting to have a bit of a problem. It's a happy problem, never mind. But, you know, during the sing-along, we have an instructor teach. Everybody sing. Occasionally, they'll stand up. They say, okay, now we stand up and exercise a bit. They exercise as they sing, some even dance. Why not? And after that, after every sing-along session, Achua and our residents will cook for the 500 participants. I think the last one we had zhima porridge. Last month, we had prawn noodle. The month before, we had char kway teow. I remember very clearly because I love to eat. I come and sing a little bit and eat a lot. That's why my size is like that. As I said, kampong spirit means being happy together, like in the two examples I told you. But it also means caring for one another. Caring for our residents who are less well-to-do. And that is why we have the ROSE program. Rice, oil, sugar, and essentials. How did the ROSE program came about? I share a little story with you. About 4 years ago, I visited one of our families. Who has some problems. So I say, okay, can I come and see you at about 7:30 p.m.? I went to the flat. Father, mother, and two young children. And as I walked into the flat, the parents opened the door and I sat in the living room. But at the side of my eye, I could see that the children and the mother was having dinner. And on the table, I remember this very clearly, was rice, one plate of vegetables, and one plate of fried eggs. That's all. So I started talking to the father, and then the father went to the fridge, opened the fridge, and got a drink out for me. I remember very clearly, it was an F&N orange can drink. When he took out that drink, the two children's eyes brightened up, because I think to them, it is a luxury. Because of my size, I don't take too much sugar drinks. My wife doesn't like it. So we opened the F&N orange, and we shared it amongst the kids. But when I went back to the community club, I told our team, I said, look, if there is one case like that in Potong Pasir, I'm sure there's another 100, 200, 300 cases. We have to care for the community. So I told them, never mind, give me 1 year. I will go out and raise money. I'll go out and raise money so that we can start our ROSE program. right? And so every first Sunday of the month, just now singing is last Sunday of the month, Rose is first weekend of the month, first Saturday of the month, you see a lot of people gathering at the CC. What are they doing? They are here to pack the rose bags. And every first Sunday of the month, the next day, they deliver the rose bag to these 350 families who are receiving help from us. What is inside the rose bag? Well, rose stands for rice, oil, sugar, and essentials. So you have rice, you have oil, you have sugar, you have biscuits, you have hand wash, toothbrush, toothpaste, canned food, fruits, all right, fruits, vegetables, fish, and chicken. Now, the vegetable and the fish and the chicken, to me, is ABCD. We only started about 6 months ago. Because we are quite familiar with how to deliver, so I say, come, let's do something more challenging. Let's deliver vegetables and fish and chicken. And all the, my volunteers say, Uyabo. I say, it can be done. That means the vegetables, the fish and the chicken come on Sunday morning, and then we deliver. Because we want to deliver it fresh for our residents. And that's ABCD. That's what we did. Each rose bag is about 15 kilograms. We vary according to the size of the household because we know each house, some have 4 people, some have 5 people, some have 6. Each rose bag is about 15 to 20 kilo. So every month, we actually pack 5 tons, 5,000 kilograms of rose bags. And I think that's very meaningful because kampong spirit means caring for one another. Potong Pasir 有一个很热门的话题, 就是我们这个甘榜精神。 首先呢, 我要讲, 就是甘榜精神 是我们Potong Pasir的特色, 是我们Potong Pasir的特点, 我要把它发扬光大。 第二点, 甘榜精神不代表说你要住在一个乡村甘榜里面, 你仍然可以有良好的设施, 也可以有这个甘榜精神的凝聚力。 我刚才举了几个例子, 比如说甘榜精神也包括了我们大家一起开心, 我们在这几年内有去过好多地方旅游, 包括了里沙路, 马六甲, 跟去槟城。 去槟城的时候, 有500位居民参与, 吃酒两巴士, 不容易的事情, 因为19两巴士一起走 16个小时到槟城, 16个小时回来。 我跟我们的工作人员讲了, 我们的目的很简单, 开开心心的去槟城, 到了槟城尽情欢乐, 然后平平安安的回来。 我们达到这个目的。 500个居民当中呢, 最年长的是90岁, 最年轻的是18个月, 1岁半, 大家都非常的开心。 我从槟城回来之后呢, 有一个居民, 他拿了一个感谢卡给我, 我说你为什么要这样给我, 他说没有, 我要谢谢你, 因为我在工作的时候, 实在太繁忙了, 我没有机会带我父母亲去旅游, 我感谢你, 跟你的团队, 带我爸爸妈妈去槟城旅游, 他们回来都很开心。 我说好, 下一次我们要去, 我会告诉你。 当然他问我, 下一次你要去哪里啊? 我说, 还在想, 但是下一次我是想, 可能去基隆坡吧, 好不好? In fact, after the Penang trip, one of our residents came to me to give me a thank you card. And I asked him, you don't have to do that. He said, no, 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 no. I want to thank you because I'm really very busy at work. I don't have time to bring my parents out for tours. I'm very happy that you organized this. My parents went there, very happy, came back, brought a lot of goodies from Penang. And of course, he asked, when is your next tour? I said, well, we're planning for our next tour sometime next year. And where are we likely to go? I said, we're thinking of going to Kuala Lumpur. I hope our residents will like that. 第二呢, 我们每个月的最后一个星期天, 在联络所里面, 都有一个活动叫大家一起唱。 就是我们的居民现在有五百位居民参与哦，起初开一年多前开始的时候，有一百五十位居民，现在有五百位居民了。居民去了那里都有一个唱歌老师，都尽情欢乐的唱歌，同时也有做一点运动，有些甚至跳舞，我觉得很好。然后唱完歌，这个节目大概中午结束之后。 阿川跟我们的居民也煮了简单的菜，午餐给我们的居民享用。我觉得这就是甘榜精神嘛，对不对？大家一起开心，一起关怀，一起照顾，对不对？讲到大家一起照应、一起照顾呢，我们也开始了我们的 Rose。 这个 Rose 的计划，我们为什么开展这个 Rose 计划？这个 Rose 计划开展了大概有3年了，因为在4年前，我去拜访一位居民，我记得很清楚。我进去的时候，我先跟他约好了7点半去他的家，然后就看到爸爸妈妈跟两个孩子，我坐下来的时候，我的眼睛旁边我看到他们在吃饭。 桌上有白饭，一道蔬菜，跟一道煎蛋。爸爸就开了冰箱，拿一罐汽水给我喝。我还记得那一罐汽水是 F&N Orange。他拿出来的时候，两个孩子的眼睛都睁大了。对我来说，就是他们也喜欢。我不能喝太多的汽水。结果当天晚上。 我们就开了这个这罐汽水跟孩子们一起享用，但是我回来之后，我告诉了我们的团队说，像这样的家庭，我们应该跟孩子们给他们多一点营养，应该帮忙他们，所以我就跟团队讲，给我1年的时间，我去筹款，1年后筹了款，我们就开展我们这个 Rose Program，Rose Program 这个 Rose 袋里面有什么呢？ 有米、有油、有糖、有饼干、有肥皂、牙刷、牙膏、罐头的食物、水果、蔬菜、鱼跟鸡肉，我觉得不错。每逢每个月的第一个星期六，我们都来包装这个 Rose 的袋，然后第二天星期天，我们就赠送这个袋去我们350个波东巴西的居民。我觉得这样的。 这样的活动是非常有意义的，对我来说，这就是波东巴西的甘榜精神。I now like to report to you and brief you on our plans for the next 5 years. If you look at our manifesto for 2011, we listed down 23 items. I checked my records. In the end, we end up doing more than 122 projects and programs. More than 5 times, big and small. In this year's manifesto for this election, we listed down 22 items. You know, once you put in writing, we have to fulfill, we have to promise, right? These 22 items are not conclusive. We will probably end up doing another 120 more. But I share with you the 22 that is in our manifesto. Now, if you look at the slogan for our manifesto, it is one vision together for 3 generations. All right? One vision together for 3 generations. The key word, in my opinion, it's 3 generations. What we're going to do is not just going to benefit the young, not just the middle-aged, not just the old. We are doing all this to benefit 3 generations of residents in Potong Pasir. And with your kind permission, I'd like to go through some of them. Let us start with Potong Pasir. Let us start with the gym. We have a gym in our community club, which is... which our residents can use free of charge. The response to our gym has greatly exceeded my expectations. I knew residents wanted a gym because you tell me so, but I didn't know it's going to be so popular. We have more than 2,800 members in the gym, all residents. Now, of course, I regularly go up to the gym to talk to the users because I, at the end of the day, it's your feedback, right? You tell me what you want, I try my best to do it. And they have told me, oh, Mr. Sito, very crowded, you know? I say, yeah, I know. And Mr. Sito, you know, your exercise equipment are very good, but you only exercise my upper body, nothing to exercise my lower body, my calf muscle, my thighs. I say, oh, sorry, because I don't go to the gym. So my size is like that. So I'm happy to promise you today, and it's in my manifesto, we will double the size of our gym. Right? There's a room next door, I will knock it down, we will double the size of our gym. We will buy better equipment, better weights, all right, more state-of-the-art equipment. All right, and I'll make sure that there is exercise equipment for your lower body. I don't know what it is, but I will do my research and I will do it. All right, we will double the size of our gym. Residents have also told me, why can't you have Wi-Fi in the CC? I said, yeah, good idea. Okay, it will be done. We will have Wi-Fi in selected spots in the CC, especially in the study room. No problem, we will do it. Next, CCTVs, surveillance cameras. I have a program where I want to install CCTVs in all the void decks in Potong Pasir and Lorong Toa Payoh, all the HDB void decks. Actually, we have already started doing it. If you go to block 101 to 109, there is a CCTV camera on all lift landings at the void deck and on all areas where there are staircases at the void deck. In other words, anybody go up and down, it's recorded. Right? And the police have told me that the crime rate in block 101 to 109 has gone down significantly. It's a much safer place. So we will do it across all the HDB flats in Potong Pasir and in Lorong Toa Payoh. Residents have also told me that they want a better bus service in Potong Pasir. Of course, I have been discussing with SBS Transit. I keep telling them, hey, your bus service can improve or not? Or can you give me another bus? Of course, they told me that they think it's good enough. But never mind, we will carry on our discussions with them. But I came across a chance. Because, you know, the land on top of the MRT station, there's a new developer that's coming in. So I went to look for the new developer. I went to look for the MD, you know, the managing director. I said, hey, welcome to Potong Pasir. He said, yeah, what do you want? I told him, why don't you do something for the community? Then he said, what do you want? I say, very simple lah. You come here, why don't you half, I half, all right? We charter a bus, 40-seater aircon bus, 7 days a week, in the morning and in the evening, peak hours, we let this bus go around all the 9 bus stops in Potong Pasir, stopping at the MRT station and the bus stop. And credit to this developer, he took a look, okay lah. So I said, okay, you say one, okay. So I said, I'm going to announce this. He said, yeah, okay. So to me, that's ABCD also. Acting beyond call of duty. So we will have a new bus service in addition to service 142. Right? That's going around Potong Pasir, stopping on all the 9 bus stops in the morning, peak hours, and in the evening, 7 days a week, to bring you to the MRT station. Incidentally, this bus service is free of charge. Right? Free of charge. Okay? If you look at our manifesto, there is an item called anti-bird barrier system. Anti-bird barrier system. And some residents have asked me, what is that? Okay, let me explain. The flats in Potong Pasir were built 31 years ago in 1984. When the architect designed these flats, there were 10 blocks that had a sloping roof. Right, you notice Potong Pasir flats have a sloping roof. Now, of course, the architect could have been very creative, but I think he overlooked a problem. This sloping roof has created big problems for our residents. It is a 31-year-old problem. Why? Because during the day, when the sun is shining very hot, the birds will go and seek shelter in this shelter sloping roof. That's okay, no problem. But the problem is, many of these birds get trapped inside and don't know how to fly out. So what happened? The birds actually die inside. I've climbed up there to look at it a few times. I've told our town council to regularly go and wash this roof. But it's not a permanent solution because the bodies of these birds decompose and they are ashes. And when the wind blows, these ashes get flown into the neighboring flats. It's very, very inhygienic. Sorry, very, very unhygienic. My English, not so good. You understand, huh? Sorry, huh? Okay, it's very unhygienic. Now, honestly, our town council does not have the resources to solve this 31-year-old problem. So I raised it in Parliament. I raised it vigorously in Parliament. The Minister for National Development, Mr. Khaw Boon Wan, answered my question. And in fact, the Minister, I told Mr. Khaw, I said, why don't you come and take a look? He said, okay, I'll come and take a look. So he came one morning, and he saw the problem. I said, Mr. Khaw, problem, 31-year-old problem. Please help me to solve it. So I'm happy to let you know, we will solve this 31-year-old problem in Potong Pasir. We are going to put nettings, all right, nettings on these 10 blocks so that the birds don't fly in anymore. We will solve this problem. I'm also happy to let our residents know that, there's an overhead bridge beside block 103. We will build a lift for this overhead bridge for our residents to use because this is following your feedback. We have a lot of elderly people who have problems climbing up. We will build a lift. As you know, we are also covering up our car parks. We are also resurfacing our car parks and we are covering up our drains, and that will be an ongoing exercise. All right, before I move to Center Estate, let me try to summarize the Potong Pasir developments in Mandarin. 现在我们要谈的就是我们每个邻里的计划。我们先谈普通巴西区的计划。当然，我们在今年的党纲呢，有列出了22个项目，但是我们在2011年的时候也有列出了23个项目，但是最终呢，我们不仅仅做这23个项目，我们做了120多个项目。 大大小小，所以你所看到的在这里呢，只是一小部分。好，因为我不要我们的党纲太厚，我只列出了基本比较重大的。但是最终我们会做，大概应该一样，这未来5年会做120多个项目以上。我们在计划这个党纲的时候，在筹备我们的5年来的期望的时候呢。 是以梦想这两个字，居民的梦想，我们的梦想，怎么打造一个更美好的家园？为什么梦想呢？如果你看这个“想”字，一个木，对不对？那个木就是好像一个人嘛，然后旁边又有一个木，那个木就是用眼睛来看，OK？ 当然，用耳朵来听你们的反应。这个“想”字下面有一个心，就是用心去做。英文呢，我们叫做 action。亏只是自己讲来讲去没有用的，我们要有 action， 要有实际的行动来做。这样我们在普通巴西区要做什么呢？第一，先谈到我们在联络所里面的健身室，大家也知道。 联络所有一个健身室是让我们的居民来使用的，免费。目前我们有2800个会员，2800位居民已经加入我们这个联络所的健身室的 的会员里面呢，很多居民也告诉了我，施督先生啊，里面很拥挤嘞，星期六、星期天、星期五的时候，很多人，我说我知道，他说哦，你买的设施不错，很好，但是我只可以锻炼我上半身，我下半身没有的锻炼，因为我的脚力、我的腿力没有的锻炼，我说哦，对不起，我不知道，因为我没有去健身房锻炼的，但是好，无所谓。 所以我们在党纲里面呢，就说明了，我们会把这个健身室扩大，双倍的扩大，因为旁边有一间房间，我们会敲开那个墙壁，然后我们会买新的设施给大家使用。当然，也有一些居民告诉我，哎，施督先生啊，你的设施我不会用嘞。 很难用，因为按来按去啊，这边又快，那边又慢，我不知道他在跟我讲，我要跟他讲话，他不懂怎么跟我讲话。你可以不可以请一个教练？然后我又算算了，我说其实可以，好，这样也答应了大家，我们会扩大我们的健身室，我们会请一个教练，好不好？You know, in the gym, there are some residents that told me, they're not familiar with how to use the equipment. They want an instructor. I've worked out the sums, it's possible. We will have an instructor for your gym. Alright? 第二点, 我们要在我们的 HDB 的主屋楼下装那个闭路电视, CCTV. 因为我们在大牌101到109 已经装了那个闭路电视, 反应非常好, 因为警察跟我讲, 装了之后呢, 那个犯罪的现象少了很多, 就是每一个电梯口, 我们都会有闭路电视, 每一个有那个楼梯的地方，我们将会装一个闭路电视，在波东巴西的每一个 HB 组屋，也以及大牌八巷的每一座 HB 组屋，好不好？好多居民也告诉了我，他们希望我们的 bus 我们的巴士服务会做得更好。当然，我们现在有这个bus 142的服务，最近我们的地铁站上面，有一块地，一个新的发展商进来了，然后我就趁这个机会去找他。当然，他说你找我干嘛？我说你来为我们的居民、我们的群众出一点力，出一点贡献，好不好？他就问我你到底要我做什么了？我说 OK， 我建议你一半，我一半，我们租一辆 bus， 40可以容纳40个乘客的 bus。 早上、晚上，星期一到星期天繁忙的时间，这辆 bus 将会走我们的9个 bus 站，一直在循环，就是走9个 bus 站到地铁站，又再走9个 bus 站到地铁站，载我们的居民去总站和地铁站。这个发展站很好，他一看了不到30秒 ，OK， 他就说，我说 OK 啊，你说 OK 的啊。 所以今天我就敢说 ，OK， 我们会有一个新的巴士服务，是免费的哈，免费，居民们不用还钱。我们在我们的党纲里面呢，有一个项目叫防鸟网，防鸟网（anti-bird barrier system）。很多居民问我，施督先生，这个防鸟网是什么？你到底在防什么 ？OK， 让我解释一下。 因为我们这里的主屋是在1984年建筑的，特点特色呢就是有一个斜坡性的屋顶，有10座主屋是这样的，10座。然后这个斜坡性的屋顶虽然是比较美观、比较特殊，但是在这31年来，从84年到现在，也给我们的居民带了不少的麻烦与不便。为什么呢？因为屋顶斜坡。 那些鸟会飞进去，为了避太阳，哦，他们会飞进去。飞进去之后呢，无所谓，很多迷了路出不来，就在里面死掉了。然后他们的骨灰呢，就吹到邻里的祖屋里面，这是非常不卫生的。而且坦白说呢，我们的市政理事会也没有这个资源。 去解决这个问题，因为要解决这个问题，老实讲很贵了，不便宜，每一座要好多的钱， 结果我在国会就提出了这个问题，也去见许文远部长，许文远部长也亲自来观察这个问题。有一天早上，我陪同他过来看。所以今天我很开心的可以告诉大家，这个31年来的问题，我们会解决，我们会建设在这些网，在这10座主屋，避免那些鸟类飞进去，好不好？除此以外呢，我们在大排103旁边有一个天桥嘛，我们也会在这个天桥建设一个电梯给大家使用，因为我们这里老人家不少嘛，所以爬上爬下的确是有一点困难我们会装一个电梯。好Now let me talk about Senate Estate. Senate Estate is a very important and uniquePart of Potong Pasir. Senate Estate comprises about 20% of our residents. Senate Estate is also the oldest private housing estate in Singapore. It is more than half a century old. There are a few items in Senate Estate I'd like to talk about. First, there is a SLA piece of land in Senate Estate surrounded by Kwang Avenue, Puay Hee Avenue,and Siakiu Avenue. I think our residents there know which piece of land I'm talking about. That used to be the Kwang Avenue Primary School and the Senat Primary School, I think 30-40 years ago. Anyway, that piece of land and the building was leased out to a private operator that used to operate a hostel there. To be very honest with you, that hostel created enormous problems for our residents. I had to take up the issue with SLA many times. I'm glad because the lease for their hostel is over, and SLA has decided not to renew the lease for this hostel. So that piece of land is now empty. SLA agrees with me, inside this land compound, there are two big fields, right? Two fields, grass fields. They agree with me that we should let our residents use these two fields. Basically, I have two objectives in the use of this piece of land, which I'm currently in discussions with SLA. Number one, whatever we do not want to disturb or inconvenience the residents nearby, particularly residents in Kwang Avenue, Puay Hee Avenue, and Siakiu Avenue. Number two, whatever we do with these two fields, and also the building there, we want it to be relevant and useful for our residents of Senate Estate. I'm not in a hurry to decide. I've told SLA, let's not rush into it. Let's go into discussion. We have started discussions, but those are the two premises. No disturbance to nearby residents, useful for all the residents. But it will be something good for all of us. Secondly, we will continue with our efforts to cover up the drains and to do the bed lane lightings for Senate Estate. I know there are parking and traffic issues in Senate Estate. We will go into continuous discussions with LTA to try to resolve them. There's one more item in Senate Estate I'd like to talk about, and that is the land at Jalan Wangi. I know there are some Jalan Wangi residents here. Now, that piece of land, again, is an SLA land. Currently, it's being rented by a VWO known as Sheng Hong. Sheng Hong is operating a childcare center there. Now, Sheng Hong has expressed interest to renew the lease. That has been done. But the government has one more condition because they're only using half that piece of land. The government wants the other piece of land, which is also leased by Sheng Hong and left vacant now, doing nothing, to be used, to be utilized for our residents. I think that's a good idea. So, we have commenced discussions with Ministry of Health. We want to have a daycare center in that Jalan Wangi compound. Daycare center opens from 7 a.m. and closes at 7 p.m. No one stays there at night. There will be nurses there by MOH to help to look after the elderly. We also want to have an activity center there so that our elderly residents can go there. Personally, I think it's a very good thing because for Senate Estate residents, when you go to work, your parents can go there, have some fun, make more friends, and if they need some medical care during the day, there are nurses there to look after them. I think it's a good thing. Okay? Now, in this same piece of land at Jalan Wangi, in the middle, in between the childcare and the proposed daycare center, in the middle, this is where we come in. We are going to raise our own money. We are going to raise our own funds. We are going to build a park for our residents to use. There will be a fitness park and there will be a playground there for our residents to use. Good? How? 现在我想说到我们在新立新村 Senate Estate 的计划。第一呢，就是在Puihi Guang Avenue 跟 Siakiu 之间有一块地，是我们 SLA 的地。之前呢是使用成为一个宿舍，但是这个宿舍带来了相当多的麻烦，这个宿舍的使用已经停止了，目前是没有人在用，但是我们已经跟 SLA 开始讨论。 要怎么使用这一块地？我们的宗旨很简单，我们用的时候不要干扰，不要骚扰，不要麻烦到附近的居民，尤其是光 Avenue 博弈跟小Q的居民。这块地里面有两个很大的操场，然后我们是希望我们的居民们可以使用这个操场。这个操场我们怎么来运作还在讨论。坦白说，我不是很急。 因为我跟 SLA 讲，我们开始讨论，开始谈判，但是最终呢，居民们要享用，但是附近的居民们不要受到任何的干扰。除此以外，我们在 Senate Estate 也会继续做有盖的沟渠，跟在后巷会装设那些灯光，然后在 Jalan Wangi。 因为我知道这里有Jalan Wangi的居民，Jalan Wangi它中间有一块地嘛，现在是这个盛虹在使用，做一个托儿所幼儿园，但是政府说他们要继续租下这一块地呢，另外一半的还没使用的地要让居民享用，所以我们现在已经跟我们的卫生部开始探讨了。 我们要做一些医疗的活动，我本身是想做一个乐龄康复中心，早上7点开门，晚上7点关门，晚上没有人住在那里的，里面会有护士，也会有一个活动中心给我们的居民使用。我觉得这是非常有意义的，因为我们的居民去工作的时候，他们的。 年长的父母亲也可以去这个活动中心，或者需要一些医疗的服务，也可以去这个康复中心使用。然后在这个幼儿园跟这个康复中心中间呢，我们会自己来筹款。好，我们会自己来筹款。我已经跟盛虹讲，他们也答应。我们会建设一个公园，小小的公园，健身公园以及儿童游乐园，让我们的居民可以使用。 好，这是我们的 Senate SA 的计划，好不好？Okay, let me talk about Lorong 8 Toa Payoh. Lorong 8 Toa Payoh, there are a few things that are already listed in our manifesto, like upgrading the courtyard at Block 210, the basketball court, covering the drains, surveillance cameras, ABC water project, which will be completed by the end of the year. So I won't talk too much, but I will talk about two things for Lorong 8 Toa Payoh that is not inside my manifesto. What are they? First Toa Payoh Primary School is currently being renovated. I have discussed with Ministry of Education. After the renovation, there will be an indoor sports complex in First Toa Payoh Primary School. MOE has given me permission. Our residents will be able to use this indoor sports complex on weekends. There will be a special door there for you to go in. So I think that's a very good thing. Second, Lorong 8 Toa Payoh residents have been asking me the last 1 year, Mr. Sito, why Potong Pasir got gym, Lorong 8 got no gym? And I tell them, gym very expensive lah. They say, yeah, I know, but you know, we like to have a gym. So I work out the sums and I tell you, no problem. I promise you here today, we will have a gym in Lorong 8 Toa Payoh. Okay?
好，现在我们谈到大排窑八项的计划，我们在板纲已经写了不少了，比如说大排210、222要做翻新等等，那个我就不讲了哈，因为时间的关系。但是有两点我必须告诉大家的，向大家汇报。第一呢，就是在 First Toa Payoh 小学现在在装修嘛，在重建嘛，我已经跟教育部谈妥了。 就是重建之后呢，在 First Toa Payoh 小学里面会有一个室内体育场，在周末的时候，我们的居民可以使用这个室内体育场。那个学校会旁边会有一个小小的门给我们的居民进出，好不好？除此以外，在这一年多内，我们浦东巴西的健身室 开始使用之后，很多八项的居民都问我：“施杜先生，为什么这里有健身室，那边没有？”我就告诉他们：“健身室很贵嘞。”他说：“我知道很贵，但是这是你的责任啊。”他们这样讲也没错啦，啊，坦白说。所以这笔账我算了，我也去参考了一些地方。所以今天我可以跟大家许诺言。 我们在大巴窑八巷将会有我们居民可以使用的建设室，好不好？I like to talk about the private estate condominiums because there has been quite a few, they have come up. We welcome them to Potong Pasir. Basically, there are two segments. One is in Mayapa Chatia Woodsville Close. The other one is in Woodleigh Close. We have already formed two neighborhood committees to look after the interests of these condo dwellers who have moved into Potong Pasir. We welcome you here. We will organize more meaningful activities through these two neighborhood committees. There's something I need to tell you, and that is that we have actually started constructing linkways outside these condos that will link you all the way to the MRT station and the bus stop in Upper Serangoon Road. All right, for both Mayapa Chatia Woodsville Close and Woodleigh Close, we have started already. They are doing the soil testing and they are about to start the construction very soon. It will be completed by the end of this year. Okay, I hope you like it. 我们这在浦东巴西区也有不少的公寓，在这几年内都搬进来的，我们非常欢迎他们。我们也设立了两个居民委员会来为这些新公寓的居民服务。他们基本上是在Mayapa Chatia Road 跟在 Woodsville Close 还有 Woodleigh Close。但是一点很重要的就是，我们在这些私人公寓的外面，在你的门口。 我们会建设有盖、有灯光的走廊，一直连到我们的地铁站跟我们的 bus 站。好，两边都会有 Woodleigh Close 那里会有 ，Woodsville Close 那里也会有，已经开始了，其实已经动工了。好，这个工程呢，在今年年底将会完成，好不好？ 。Next, I want to talk a little bit about hardware, H-E-A-R-T, hardware. Because for a community like Potong Pasir to thrive, we must have hardware. We are going to organize, we have been organizing good causes, but we are going to organize more causes, as I said, for three generations of residents in Potong Pasir. One of them, for example, we have already started getting quotations for iPads. We want to buy maybe about 100 iPads. So that our children can learn how to use them, but just as importantly, so that our senior citizens can learn how to use them. And if you can play games on them, so be it. Everybody must be happy. right? We will also have other programs like health checkups, eye checkups, dental checks. Now, one of the things I want to talk about is pets. As I visit our Potong Pasir households, I notice that many of our households, whether it's Potong Pasir, Lorong 8, or Senate Estate, or even the condos, they have pets. They have dogs and pets. We had a pet carnival recently in our CC. I at first thought we'll have 50 people coming, but actually we had 200 participants coming to the pet carnival recently. So this gives me motivation and encouragement to do more for our pets, for our pet lovers. Okay, so you will see in our manifesto, I have already promised you there will be more pet activity corners in Potong Pasir. We will have them in Potong Pasir, in Lorong 8, and in Senate Estate. More places for you to interact with your pets. Maybe some grooming, some training. We will seek your consultation and your advice because you know your pets best, right? Now, there's also been a request for there to be a dog run in Potong Pasir. Okay, a dog run is a place where you can unleash your dog and your dog can run freely. Personally, I like the idea, but I have been talking to the agencies. They don't like my idea because they say, oh, this land is reserved for this, that land is reserved for that, and you know, the maintenance is a problem. But never mind, we are ABCD people, all right? We act beyond the call of duty. I think I found that piece of land in Potong Pasir. I won't tell you where because I still need to clear the agency, but I think it can be done. So I promise you, we will have a dog run in Potong Pasir. All right. Now, we just opened the Kallang River. Beautiful, isn't it? 400 meters. The trees, the plants, and the shrubs have just been planted. They are going to settle down. I intend to wait till the end of the year when the plants have settled down. And then we will be a bustling Kallang River. On weekends, all right, we don't want to disturb the households there. On weekends, during the daytime, we will organize more meaningful activities along the Kallang River so that our residents can enjoy and can use. How about? 好，现在我想谈到我们在新建这方面所要做的计划，心里的心哈，更多的活动，使到我们的本期的居民更开心。 觉得人生更有意义。首先呢，我们会主办更多的活动，来为我们Potong Pasir三代居民造福，for three generations，三代居民造福。我们其实已经开始要购买大概100个 iPad， 让我们的学生小朋友使用，同时也希望我们的乐龄人士可以学习，可以使用。 好，我们也会安排更多的卫生上的检查、眼睛的检查、身体检查、牙齿的检查等等。除此以外呢，我们在我们的档案里面也有写了，我们有一个宠物的角落，好，不管是狗还是其他的宠物，我们会主办更多为你们的宠物的活动，而且也会有角落。 也会有一个我不知道中文怎么讲，一个dog run，就是你可以带你的狗，你去那边遛狗，然后你可以放你的狗，让它自由的跑。我看我已经找到了地方，多两三个月谈妥了，我会告诉大家那个地方在哪里，是在Potong Pasir，不会骚扰到居民的。好，但是我们的宠物的喜爱者可以跟他们的宠物一起享受，好不好？好。 我们在嘉冷河畔刚刚开展给大家使用嘛，400米很漂亮。等那些那里的草草木木稳定下来，我们会在嘉冷河畔举行更多的活动，让大家尽情享用。I want to tell you and share with you a little story. 2 days ago, I was at Block 143 at my branch. A group of students ran past me. I asked them, what level are you? They say, primary 2. I say, oh, where are you going? say, oh, we are going to the CC. I think there were about five of them. Then they all five turned back, and then they say, Mr. Sito, can we ask you a question? I say, sure, what is your question? They said, my grandmother tells me, one of them asked me, my grandmother tells me, you look after the elderly in Potong Pasir very well. Is that true? I told them, yes, we look after three generations. We try our best to look after three generations well, the young, the middle-aged, and the elderly. But I told them a story I'd like to share with you. I told them, you know, when you were born, when you were a baby, when you were lying on inside the baby cot, when daddy and mommy comes to you, naturally as a baby, your instinct reaction is you stretch out your arms, right? Why? Because you want daddy and mommy to carry you. And immediately, daddy and mommy will carry you in their arms to give you all the love and all the warmth that they want to give to you. But when daddy and mommy grow old, maybe not so fit, some in a wheelchair, they are not going to stretch out their arms to their children and tell you, please look after me. But I'm sure all of you agree with me here. As children, we must always look after our parents. As your MP here, it is also my responsibility to look after the elderly. And that's why, yes, I do pay a lot of attention to the elderly here. So please share my conviction to want to do this. I believe in it, and we will do it. 我想跟大家分享一个故事，真的故事啊，不是假的啊。几天前有几个小学生 St. Andrews 的学生，他们经过了我小学二年级的，然后他们就问了我一个问题，他说：“师徒先生，我的奶奶跟我讲啊，你很照顾老人家嘞，是不是真的？”我说：“对，我不仅仅照顾老人家，我照顾普通巴西三代居民，小的中年人以及老人家。” 然后我就告诉他们，听我一个故事好不好？当你是婴孩的时候，你睡在婴孩的床上，爸爸妈妈在你面前，你自然而然就把你的双手拿起来。为什么呢？因为你要爸爸妈妈抱你，爸爸妈妈也会马上抱你，因为他们疼爱你，他们要给你感受到他们对你的爱，对你的温暖。 但是当爸爸妈妈年老了之后呢，有些坐在轮椅，他们是不会拿起双手说叫孩子照顾他们的，这不是我们的文化。但是身为子女，身为孙，我们有这个责任来照顾我们的爷爷奶奶，我们的爸爸妈妈。身为您的一员，我也有这个责任。 来照顾我们的年老乐龄人士，对不对？好，所以在这方面希望大家可以支持我。I now want to turn to some of the comments that have been made by Mrs. Lina Chiam and the SPP. The SPP mentioned that Mrs. Chiam spoke more than me in Parliament. Is that true? Yes, that is true. But I like to draw an analogy. We all love to watch Jackie Chan movies, correct or not? Jackie Chan movies. But Jackie Chan make how many movies a year? One. Chinese New Year, one show a year. Always a box office show, correct? So my point is, really, we have to look at the quality of the questions and the quality of the topics that you speak in Parliament. You know, there was once an NMP that asked a question on what is the sulfur content in the air several years ago. Well, she's entitled to ask that question, but my point is, how does it affect Potong Pasir residents? I have spent a lot of time asking issues relating to Potong Pasir, whether it's the flooding in Senate Estate, the hawker stall prices in Lorong 8, the road expansion, the family service center, the bird droppings, walkways, surveillance cameras, rats and rodents, even the 400-meter track in Cedar School, St. John's Home, etc., etc. I'm here for you. I ask questions that affect you. I talk about issues of the elderly Why? Because there are many elderly in Potong Pasir. I talk about issues that affect your daily lives. I don't talk for the sake of talking. We put into action. Correct. Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you. Talk is cheap. Okay. Thank you. 我现在想谈一些这几天来Mrs. Jam 跟 SBB 所提出的一些话题。第一，他讲他在国会里面发表的时间比我多，那是对的。但是呢，我想强调一点，比如说成龙，我们都想看，很想看成龙的电影嘛。成龙的电影一年一部戏而已，每一部戏都破纪录，所以多不代表是好。 像我在国会发言的全部是关系到我们波东巴西居民居住生活的问题，包括了我们的区里面有老鼠，我们区里面的鸟粪，包括了我们的停车场等等等等。所以我想讲的就是多不代表是好。Second point, I see a lot of emphasis yesterday in SBP's rally here on Mr. Chiam See Tong's legacy. Let me say this clearly. Mr. Chiam's 27-year-old legacy in Potong Pasir is intact. I have no intention to displace it. I have no intention to replicate it. Let me give you one very simple example. When I took over the town council in 2011, the staff told me, Mr. Sito, we have to change the logo and the slogan. You know the slogan is my kind of town, right? I turned to the staff, why do you want to change? He said, oh, fresh beginning, fresh face. I said, no. I said, my friend, you change slogan, you change logo, means you got to change all the letterhead, means you got to change all the posters. All this costs money. I'm not going to waste money on such things. And quite honestly, as far as I'm concerned, me and my team, work, 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 deliver, deliver, deliver. That must be our motto. <音><音>在昨天SBP的群众大会, 他们花了不少的时间来讲詹时中在这里的贡献。我想讲一点，詹时中先生在这里的贡献，我们是无法代替的。我们也没有这个打算要代替。就因为你说 这个市政理事会的标志跟它的宣言 My Kind of Town， 我根本没有换到，因为对我来说，我们的宗旨是我们要工作，我们要用心的去为我们的居民打造一个更美好的家园，一个无限关怀、处处温馨的家园，对不对？ I am not here to claim credit. If Mrs. Jam or SBP want to claim credit, go ahead. I don't mind. I just want to deliver. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. I give you another example. I think at the rally here yesterday, Mrs. Jam said, oh, the lift upgrading, lift on every floor, it opened after 3 months. 3 months after the last general election. In May 2011. So she wants to claim credit for that. Say, oh, that's Mr. Chiam work. If she wants to claim credit, fine, I don't mind. But I went to check, because since she mentioned, I have to go and check. She's wrong. Her information is wrong. The lifts did not open 3 months after, as she claimed. The lifts opened 1.5 years later, in August 2012. So I just want to clarify that. Mr. Jam 在昨天的群众大会也讲了，在2011年三个月大选之后，那些每一座主屋的电梯都可以开放给居民使用，所以功劳应该归于 Mr. Jam。我在这里不是要抢任何功劳，即使 Mrs. Jam 要拿功劳，我也无所谓，因为我们的宗旨是要为我们的居民服务。但是我查了，那些电梯不是三个月后就 开始给居民使用，那些电梯是1年半后，在2012年的8月份开始给我们的居民使用。 Mrs. Cham also mentioned about the SNCC arrears, saying that we write off SNCC arrears. How much did we write off? Not 1 cent. Zero. I did not write off. But since the topic was brought up, I want to share something with you. When we took over the Town Council in May 2011, there were 402 units in arrears. 402 units. That's very high. That's almost 10% in arrears. That means haven't been paying the SNCC. The SNCC arrears was $300,000+. The highest was a family that owned more than $8,000. He hasn't been paying for almost 3 years. Now, to me, this is unfair because we have 5,500 households in Potong Pasir, HDB. If 10% don't pay and 90% pay, that's not fair. So what did I do? I went to visit these 402 families and I asked them, please tell me your problem. I will help you. I will help you, but you cannot just throw away the SNCC invoice. I will help you to pay, or I'll help you in one way or another, but you must tell me your problem. We co-share the problem, all right? So they shared with me. And today, I'd like to let you know, the number of households in area have decreased by more than half. The amount is also a lot less. So this is the approach we take in Potong Pasir. We are a community. If anybody have a problem, I'm not going to leave you alone. Please come and see me. Please come and see Achua. I cannot solve all your problems, but I promise you, I will try my best to lighten your burden. Because we talked about this杂费的事，昨天 Mrs. Cham 讲了，哦，我们的杂费收不回来呢，就把它取消掉。但是我们其实是没有这样做的。 没有一分钱被取消到。2011年，我们接手的时候，有402个单位，没有还杂费，那是很多，大概10%。最高的是8000元以上，大概3年没有还杂费。我觉得这个对其他的居民们是非常不公道，非常不好。我们不能有一个情况说有90%有还，10%没还。 所以呢，我们接管之后，我们就去拜访这些居民，问了他们，可以不可以跟我讲你的问题到底在哪里？我会帮你的，好，我会帮你的。我不能解决全部波东巴西居民的问题，但是你跟我讲，或者你跟阿传讲，我可以在这里强调，在这里许个诺言，我会尽量尽我每一份力量来减轻你的负担，好不好？ 所以正因为这样，我们今天这个杂费还欠的数额呢，已经减了很少，家庭呢也减了一半以上。Now the other thing that Mrs. Cham mentioned, oh, I did not use the upgrading funds properly, because I tore down some of the walkways. That is correct. But actually, I don't even want to talk about it. I told my people don't talk about it. Just replace the walkways, and that's it. But since it's mentioned, I owe you an explanation. Now, why did we replace those walkways? Two reasons. Because number one, those walkways are old, really old. And I really want our residents to have better walkways to walk on, better shade from the sun, better shelter from the rain. The second and more important reason. Those old walkways, the roof material was made from polycarbonate. Polycarbonate is combustible. Polycarbonate is a fire hazard. In today's standards, polycarbonate is not allowed to be used for walkways. Well, to be fair, I would imagine that when those walkways were built in the past, polycarbonate was allowed. I don't know, but to be fair, I would imagine they must have been allowed last time. But in today's context, because polycarbonate is hazardous to fire, it is not allowed. So it's a safety issue. And some of these walkways are actually very near to the flats. I'm not going to risk safety, correct? Especially when they're near our residence flats. That's why I changed it. I hope you can accept my explanation. Mrs. Cham 昨天也谈到了, 因为有一些走廊之前是 Mr. Chang 建的，我把它拆掉，然后我建新的。对，我是把它拆掉。其实这件事情我是不想谈的，但是我把它拆掉，因为这些旧的走廊，他们所用的原材料是叫 polycarbonate， 是一种 plastic， 比较容易着火的，比较容易着火，在目前的安全条例是不可以使用的。我想可能他们之前建的时候应该是可以使用，应该是可以。 但是今天是不允许的，就因为这样，我建新的走廊，让我们的居民使用。好，太阳晒的时候他们会更舒服，下雨的时候他们走的时候也可以挡雨。所以这个是安全的问题，我一定要换的，没办法。希望大家可以接受我的解释。Last point, Mrs. Jam also said that, You should spend the money to help our needy residents for their medical bills. Thank you for the feedback, Mrs. Chiam. Thank you, but we are already doing that. She may not be aware, we have a MediAssist program to help our residents. All right, how does it work? Our residents go and see the doctor. They get their claims. They show us the receipt. We will help to pay part of their medication costs. Not a lot, sometimes we pay 100, 150, but the point I want to make to our residents is that, especially our senior citizens, if you need to see a doctor, please go and see a doctor. Please take your medication regularly, because there have been cases of residents who don't do that for one reason or another. Please take your medication regularly, and if you need help, come and claim from us. Right now, under our MediAssist program, we have about 150 residents in the program. 好，昨天 Mr. Jam 也谈了，你应该把这些钱用在医疗来帮忙我们的居民，感谢他的提议。但是我们已经有了，我们有一个医疗援助计划，是来协助我们的区的居民，如果需要我们的帮忙，我们会帮他们付一部分的医疗的费用。 I now like to conclude. You know, when I was growing up in the flats in Upper Aljunied Road, the 10-story flats at Block 2, Upper Aljunied Road, my parents always taught me that when someone gives you a chance, you must grab it with both hands, you must treasure it, and most importantly, you must deliver. We have done everything we could in the last 4.5 years. We have delivered. But today, I stand before you because I need your help. I hope you can help us to vote for us, to give us another chance, so that together and collectively, we will build a Potong Pasir, a better Potong Pasir for everyone. Please. <笑>童年时代呢，我的父母亲经常教导我， 说，如果有人给我们机会，我们要把握，我们要珍惜。人海茫茫，我们大家能聚在这里，也算是我们的缘分。我真的很需要大家的帮忙，希望在这次的大选，大家能够再给我们一个机会，为您服务，为您效劳。 让我们共同一起打造一个更美好的波东巴西家园，好不好？谢谢大家 ，Thank you very much.